throwing petrol bombs at security forces. Do you see this as an unfair verdict, or what do you think about it?
Obviously, the Saudi Arabia record for human rights is obviously zero. It's not only about the Shia, it's about Sunni and generally human beings. And as an American citizen and as a Muslim, I feel shame that Saudi Arabia is the closest friend and ally of United States in the Arab world, a country that provided at least 15th of 19 terrorists in 9/11, a country with zero respect for freedom of expression and human dignity, a country that its policy is corrupting and contaminating the not only in Bahrain under occupation, but in Iraq, in Syria, in Lebanon. The whole Middle East looks like the money of Saudi Arabia is a cancer for the entire Middle East. It is against Shia, it's against Sunni, anti-human beings. And it is unfortunate that all this corruption and crimes happen in the name of religion and in the name of God. Unbelievable that in 21st century, the women in Saudi Arabia have no right even to drive. So it is embarrassing. But obviously, using the Shia-Sunni tool to bring more torture and pain and suffering for the innocent people is being used by Saudi Arabia for a long time. But if you look at Egypt, in Egypt it's not Shia and Sunni issue, but still Saudi cancerous policies are dividing and corrupting that country as well. Yes, it is unfortunate that they are against any voice that is for freedom, for justice, for human rights, for human dignity. And the case of Bahrain, obviously, is one of the very, very clear example of injustice and oppression of the Saudi regime that is afraid of losing its power among the people in the Middle East. They continue these painful policies against the people all over. The example of...
I'm afraid we are running out of time, but thank you very much for being with us. Mr. Mohammed Elahi, Imam of the Islamic House of Wisdom, with us there live from Michigan. What I'd like to ask,
thank you.
Story on the solution of the...